So that's because the thread break detector, every once in a while, is getting like a one.
And that's why you've got a repeat signal before it gives you the trigger warning.
Correct. Correct.
It's not in front of the sensor at the time.
So where it's happening is when it hits that rotation, and I think it's the tension on the wire is affecting. It's not letting the spring hit the it's not letting it check all the way up, and that's why that light blinks for just a second, but it's only for one stitch, so the machine doesn't stop.
Assuming that the feed on the wire spool is based off of how much it's jogging.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
I didn't think it was tension based, just looking at it.
And there's a default based on what we load in the program, and then there's an extra compensation. So for whatever reason we needed more wire or something like that, we can add more in the control panel.
Beats doing it by hand.
Can we get the CS-14 out of the way?
Sure, of course.